Did you know that in sessions we have something called rooms? Not breakout rooms, we have those too, but this is something different. A room is a session that can be accessed 24/7 via a permanent link. So, for example, say that you've created Susie's room. You'll get a link that stays the same forever. You can share it with others and they can meet with you in your room whenever the need arises. Let's take a look at how to set up a room. From Sessions Home, click on Rooms and then on New Room. Give your room a name and make sure that you are happy with the URL because this is the link that you'll send to others to join a meeting and you won't be able to change it later. You can decide if you want to lock your room or not. This means that you'll have to give someone permission before they can enter. If this is toggled off, anyone with the link will be able to go straight into your room. Also, you can decide if you want your video stream to take up as much of the screen space as possible when you record. Note that this may reduce its overall quality. Next, you can write a description for your room if you would like to. Now that the general setup is done, you can decide if you want to add an agenda to your room. This means that every time someone enters the room and a new meeting starts, that agenda will show up. If you remove it during one meeting, it will be visible again in the next one. Let's move on to settings. Here, the important thing to remember is that these will be the overriding settings for all the meetings you have in your room. So, say for example that you set it so that participants will join with their cameras off, then this setting will apply every single time someone enters your room. You can change it during a meeting, but then the changes will apply to that specific meeting only. If you want the change to be permanent, you would need to go to the room's main settings and edit it there. Right, so under Access Settings, you can decide whether you want someone to type in their email address when they join your room. This is useful if you need to collect their contact information or if you want to send them takeaways from your meeting. You can also decide whether they'll be able to view and recap your session in memory. If so, they'll be able to access chat messages, the transcript, agenda, recording, and more. Under Participants' Permissions, you can choose who'll be allowed to send reactions, share their screen, and switch on their camera and microphone. You can also decide if you want inactive participants to be visible or not. Under Widgets, you can choose exactly what options you would like to show up on screen. For example, if you'll only use chat and transcript, you can remove all the others. This brings us to automations. If these are toggled on, then all the sessions in your room will be automatically recorded and transcribed. When you are done, click on Create Room. Once your room is created, it will show up here, under Rooms. You can enter it from here, you can copy the room link, and you can view its different options if you click on the three-dot menu. If you click on a room, you'll find all your past meetings and you'll be able to delete or review them in memory. Last but not least, you can share your room with others, either with everyone in your workspace or with specific people. This means that they'll also be able to host meetings in the room you've created. Now that everything is done and set up, let's enter my room. It looks just like a normal session and it has the agenda and widgets that I chose. From here, I can also copy the link and send it to someone. And I can change settings if I need to. But remember, they'll only apply to this specific session. Once I end the session, it will move into memory like any other session would. Or if everyone leaves the room but no one ends the session, it will automatically end after 15 minutes of inactivity. And there you have it, the main things you need to know about rooms.